Today in the news, we've got a Samsung ad that came up early, repair kits from Palmer Lucky, and answers from Nvidia. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with a quickie from Samsung. Their annual Unpacked event is happening today, where we expect them to release at least three new phones, the S10, S10e, and S10 Plus. This video will go live before the actual event, but it looks like the Norwegian channel TV2 didn't get the memo because they aired a promotional ad for the S10 Plus a day in advance. Punch out Infinity O display, on-screen fingerprint reader, triple camera setup, and more have been confirmed, and it looks like we're going to get a pair of Bluetooth headphones for the S10 line. I guess all that's left is info on the foldable phone, and we'll just have to wait a few hours for that. According to serial leaker Even Blass, it's going to be called the Galaxy Fold. I like it, it's simple. Next up, the Oculus co-founder Palmer Lucky is doing something quite selfless for the company, even though he left it. He stayed in touch with the VR community and saw that a lot of Rift headsets had audio issues, mine included. Since he felt bad about selling a product with a flaw, he is giving out free repair kits for Rift owners, even those out of warranty, like me. What's great about the repair kits is that it also adds a headphone jack so you can connect your own pair of headphones to the headset. You first have to try your luck with Oculus before requesting a repair kit, but it's really refreshing to see someone stand behind his product like that, even if he doesn't work for the company anymore. And then we have Nvidia. Their DLSS technology went under the microscope of many outlets, and most didn't like what they found. While performance was definitely improved in Metro Exodus, when we add DLSS to ray tracing, the image actually looked a lot softer and blurrier. It seems like Nvidia took notice and released a blog post to answer some of the questions that were raised. Let's look at part of that Q&A about DLSS. First, why isn't it available at all resolutions? While Nvidia takes three paragraphs to explain it, let me try and make it simple. DLSS takes a specific amount of time to do its thing, and it has to do it for every frame. If your game is running at 30 frames per second, then it has enough time to DLSS your image between each frame. But if your game is running at, let's say, 144 frames per second, the time between the frames is too small and DLSS won't fit, so it's disabled. This specific sentence sums it up. Your GPU's frame rendering time may be shorter than the DLSS execution time. That makes me wonder if it's the tensor cores that are too slow or just the actual code for DLSS. Next question, some users mentioned blurry frames. Can you explain? First of all, they're saying blurry frames like it's only specific ones. No, the whole image got softer with DLSS, Nvidia. Don't try and hide it. To answer this one, they say that at lower resolutions, they have less source data, which makes sense. So that's what causes the softness. As you probably know, 4K DLSS is sort of an upscaled 1440p. So at 1080p, it's more like upscaled 720 to 900p. The image that it's upscaled from has a lot less pixels, so the DLSS process looks softer. They say that they're working on improving this by adding more training data to the deep learning network. That still doesn't explain why DLSS can still look softer at 4K. Here's the problem that I see. It looks like training the AI for a game takes tremendous amount of time and resources. So it's clear that not every game can benefit from it, especially not indie devs. And Nvidia themselves say that upscaled TAA is preferred and better in some cases. While it might fall down in certain ways, like Nvidia puts it, why not just improve it rather than shoving DLSS in our faces? I mean, last year, Nvidia was working on ATAA, which looked promising, and we haven't heard from that since. Anyways, what do you guys think about DLSS? Do you think the image will get better with time? Let me know down below. Alright, so that concludes today's episode. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to drop me a like down below before leaving your comment. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you guys on the next one. I gotta go win a victory royale again.